Hello, everyone. I wanted to apologize for the last video. I repeated myself, and I didn't trim off the excess on the movie maker. That's free. I didn't even realize that. I just went to Starbucks. Had to call the narc. This is the effect he has on me. Just to reassure me that the car is actually going to be repaired or paid for anyway once it's repaired. I can't tell him what auto body shop I'm going to, who's doing it, or what, just that he needs to pay for it once they call him. That's what he's pissed about. I'm exhausted, holding the fort, basically. I've had to do all the work, not even realizing what he was doing the whole time at all. Not at all. I was trusting what he was saying to me most of the time. And the truth is, you can't trust anything that comes out of this guy's mouth. Because it's always a manipulation. He's creating more evidence to use against me. That's what he does. He tells a story, and for narcissistic supply, he gets his attention. And then what he does is he manipulates people around to create the evidence that he needs to prove to everyone that he was right. He's doing it again. Oh, he won't stop. They're compulsive. That's why they have OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder. They have these compulsions. They can't stop. It's like a gambler. Someone who would gamble away the mortgage on the house, even though he has like a nice house and two kids and great job. He'll piss it away just to feed his addiction. So anyway, I'm exhausted. I'm gonna go back to bed because I had to call him to get reassurance that he's actually gonna pay for the car once it gets fixed. Ah, doubt that'll happen. Yeah, and he called me a lazy ass. Yeah. When I said I wasn't going to do the yard anymore, because fall is coming and oh my God, the leaves. You wouldn't believe it. It would just in my tiny backyard, 8 bags of leaves I will get every week, to get to recycling. It's a huge amount, and that's me shredding them as well. It's, I can't even explain like what this feels like. This is just unreal because he sets up the traps and you walk right into them. And it's all about a story he's been telling for the last, well, I don't know, 17, 18 years. How this is going to end for him. And nobody else knows this. Of course not. Sick fucking people, man. But anyway, I'm going to probably repeat myself again and apologize for repeating myself and not trimming the footage. So I'm exhausted. I'm going to go back to bed. And I'm grateful for that, that I have a roof and a bed. Air conditioning, that's for sure. Lately, anyway. But we finally reached fall, and this is a hard time of year. This is a lot of hard work. For me, anyway. In case you didn't know, I have degenerative disc disease. Had the neck surgery with metal plates, and I had the broken vertebrae in my lower vertebrae. So, among other things, it's hard for me to do this stuff. I do it anyway. But arthritis is setting in, and it's not because I'm that old, it's just because is what it is. I can tell you what's going to go on or what's been going on in a little while, but I really can't divulge too much information anymore. It's helping him out too much. I'm going to trim this one this time. Peace out.